bow break, let it come down, crash. Let the sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent. Cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you what I've strung together. The very first words of a lifelong.
All right, thank you so much.
You feel good, right?
I do.
Yeah.
I feel excellent.
It's you.
Memphis, Tennessee?
Yes.
And tell me what brings you here.
A lot of jaw pain, a lot of headaches, a lot of neck pain and shoulder pain.
How long has it been going on?
For about almost 4 years.
4 years. Mm-hmm. Did you wear braces?
I did.
How old were you when they came off?
15.
And how old are you now?
Almost 26.
So around 22, you started having these pains, right?
Correct.
Between, say, 18 and 22, you had no issues?
None.
What did you have done at age 22 that you can coincide with your pain?
A lot of dental work, a lot of root canals, a lot of crowns.
Yeah. So after that dental work was done, that you just mentioned, fillings, crowns, etc., that's when the pain started?
Mm-hmm. Correct.
And I assume you went back to the dentist and you were like, hey, this is what's happening, right?
Right.
So what they do? They hit you up with more root canals? Let's try this. Let's see if this is where the pain's coming from.
They tried shaving some teeth down, filing some teeth down. She ordered me a night guard splint.
Yeah. Did it help?
No.
No.
Not at all.
So when they were shaving the teeth down, they were using the bite ribbon, the paper, the colored stuff, weren't they?
Correct. Mm-hmm.
And did you find that it helped or that it hurt subjectively in your...
It really didn't make a difference too much.
Yeah. So every time they'd work on something, it was... It was worse, not better.
Right.
Or the same.
Right.
Describe your pain. Can you point to where it is? Like in the temples, in the cheek, in the neck, where?
It's right here, right, like I guess where your jaw opens and closes.
Right.
Right there.
In the TMJ itself.
Right. And then I guess as it gets worse, it kind of leads into like right here, like right in front of your ear.
Okay.
And then it just kind of bleeds down.
Down, mm-hmm. Like on the trapezius behind your neck?
Mm-hmm.
Is it both-sided, or is it worse on one side than another?
It is on both sides, but it is worse on my left side than it is on the right.
What else should we know? What else? What helps you, like medication-wise? What have you tried?
Anti-inflammatories do seem to help, and muscle relaxers seem to help with sleeping at night.
Yeah. So when you wake up in the morning, are you really tired and sore?
I used to be. The muscle relaxers seemed to help with that a little bit.
Yeah, and then the anti-inflammatories, you told me that it's torn up your stomach so bad that you're like staying off of them, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. I'd stay away from those.
Yeah, did they ever give you narcotics for it? Or?
No. I did get prescribed a cream that I can put like on the muscle itself.
Did it help?
It does help.
Yeah.
It helps a little bit.
So who did you see for all this over the years?
I've seen my primary doctor, I've seen a dentist, TMJ dentist, chiropractor, and physical therapist.
You went to multiple dentists though, right?
Yes.
Even a university, if mm-hmm. I recall.
Mm-hmm.
And you told me that the university TMJ person shot an MRI, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they were looking at the joint.
Mm-hmm.
And what did she tell you?
By looking at the MRI pictures, that if she wasn't looking at me, she would think that she saw a joint of a 50-year-old woman.
Okay, so she said things were pretty worn down?
Yeah.
All right. And what did she make of that? Did she make you splints? Did she...
What she called orthotics.
Orthotics.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the orthotics, she told you that this was a permanent fix or not? What did she say?
She was hoping for a permanent fix, that my bite would adjust to
the new place?
Yes.
The new position?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So she didn't touch the way the teeth came together at all. She just gave you plastic.
Yes.
So did you find that they helped?
They did help a little, but it was nowhere near
resolved
at all, no.
Yeah, and if you take it out, it's gone back to nothing.
Oh, when I take them out, I mean, I'm back to where I started. I mean,
gotcha. So there's no fix. It's like taking a pill for something temporary.
It's like a Band-Aid.
So aside from the MRI, did anyone bother imaging you, like with a cone beam, with CT, looking at bone, anything like that?
No, I don't believe so.
No.
No.
How did you find us?
Through a TMJ discussion group on Facebook.
They never got the bite right, and that's what started the spasm,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, sometimes the orthodontics will be the genesis of the problem.
Yeah.
With you, it was 4 years later.
Mm-hmm.
We assume that it was partly the orthodontic movements,
mm-hmm.
but it sounds to me like definitively someone's been messing with the way things relate. And that's my prayer, that the joints aren't as messed up and we don't have an MRI on you today. Do you find the cold sensitivity is like varying like day by day or not?
No.
Pretty consistent?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, you want that straw when you go to the restaurant and get ice water, right?
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Never noticed that.
Yeah.
It's just whatever.
Didn't you tell me you also stick your tongue between your teeth? Is that pretty chronic? Like you'll smile in a picture and you'll look at, that's my tongue.
No, I never noticed it like that, but
But it's there.
Yeah. I mean, especially when I don't have my mouthpiece in.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like almost automatic.
Yeah. Huh? Remember, that's nature's splint.
Yep.
Yep. You have a headache right now?
A little bit.
Where's that? Back
right
there?
Here. Yeah.
So you walked in with that?
Yes.
Is this like average?
Mm-hmm.
It's not terrible, but it's like, God, this sucks. It's just this dull throb or
yes.
what?
Yes. Yes.
Got it. See, it's possible that the cartilage is messed up on the left side, and that's why you're banging into that up that left side molar so bad.
Uh-huh.
It's also possible that they just didn't put it in the right place in space and time. If that's all it is, this is going to be easy. If the cartilage is ripped forwards, there's a thickness of the cartilage, and all of a sudden muscles pull jaw higher.
Uh-huh.
So back teeth are close to the joint, so they're more likely to whack harder.
Okay.
That would be a bad thing.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Because it's the genesis of the problem would be cartilage and not tooth and restoration.
Right.
Because if this is all this is going to be a slam dunk.
Mm-hmm.
If this guy is still in good shape,
mm-hmm.
cartilage,
mm-hmm.
working on the bite is going to be easy. Okay. Again, consistently, you're banging too hard on that one left molar,
mm-hmm.
which has been restored, by the way. That's part of where your dental work is.
Mm-hmm.
As you swing off to the side, to your left side, when you look at muscle, this guy's supposed to be active,
mm-hmm.
but this guy's supposed to be shut down, the opposite temple, but he's not. All these spikes.
Yeah.
It's like he's sputtering. He can never shut down because the way the teeth come together incites that engine to keep revving.
Right.
So he never gets a break. Okay. And now go off to the left.
Okay.
Your one-year-old fillings. The anatomy, they laid it down flat. Teeth aren't flat on the tops. They've got grooves and hills and valleys.
Uh-huh.
So the first thing I'm taking away from you, it's not even natural tooth structure. It's artificial that they didn't put in right. We call that iatrogenic. Iatrogenic meaning it's artificially introduced.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of makes sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're refurbishing your machine part because you have a cavity, but they never bother taking the time to put it in where it belongs. Relative to space and time. So it's all about timing.
Mm-hmm.
And this doesn't show you time, this shows you where.
Right.
Doesn't show you when, doesn't show you how much. It shows you, it rubbed, maybe, and sometimes it even misses that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. This is a typewriter. What we're dealing with is like Microsoft Word.
Oh, yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Get in there. Good. They're back. Teeth together, what's it feel like?
Feels much more like it fits.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Not so clunky?
Mm-mm.
Guess who's getting there on one side already?
Yay.
If this isn't cartilage, Or if it is, it's, remember I told you about the two halves, lateral and medial pole? If it's just lateral pole, which usually that's the first one to go, and the crown, this will still work. Okay. If it's medial pole, we're in trouble. Okay. Not trouble, it's not going to make it worse, it's just it's not going to help that much. But honestly, I feel good about this because we've done almost nothing. But it's a big deal. Left, open. Almost got it. They're back. That way.
That was pretty good.
Pretty darn good, isn't it? We're only halfway done. What's your number?
This is like zero, and this is still maybe like a five.
Yeah, because I haven't even touched that.
Right. Yeah, so this is number zero.
How cool is that?
That's pretty cool.
So what was that 20 minutes ago?
Like a six or seven.
Yeah. Now I've kind of sliced it in half, haven't I?
Yep.
That chapter in that textbook that I wrote, you're a great example.
Oh, really?
Yep. It's a cure for sensitive teeth, but nobody listens. I'm okay with that. Fools.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Go spend your $3 billion a year on sensitivity toothpaste, and oh yeah, by the way, it's related to pain, like real muscle pain. What's your neck feel like?
Feels really good.
Feel a big difference?
Huge.
How about your face? What's it feel like?
Feels good.
Come on, doesn't anything feel bad anymore? It's changing though. You're starting to, the sputtering's starting to go away. When you first swished this morning, you were like 6 out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
So then in the middle of it all, we did one side, and you swished, and you were nothing on that one side.
Right.
And you were still the same on that side, on the right? Mm-hmm. So left was 0, and that was the same.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to see what you do now.
Okay.
See all this? See how the muscles flatlined? You're not, I mean.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's like beautiful.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So what's it feel like right now, subjectively? I mean, describe in your own words. Compared to when you walked in, you told me you had a little headache. Do you have it?
Yeah.
It's gone?
No. Mm-mm. It's gone.
What else?
It feels really relaxed.
Do you feel sleepy?
A little bit.
A lot of people feel sleepy.
Mm-hmm.
Swish with it. A lot of ice in that. What do you got?
Maybe a 1 or 2.
Maybe.
Yeah.
It's different though, isn't it?
A lot.
Just cold. It doesn't hurt.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
It doesn't hurt at all.
All right. Give me a high five. Get her JVA and EMG.
Okay.
Get a CEREC in here and I'll be back in a few minutes.
Okay.
Okay, so it's been what? Hour and a half?
Mm-hmm.
You went to lunch. How do you feel?
Feel good.
Did you eat okay? Was it different?
It was different.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, it felt like I was eating with a new mouth.
You're smiling all over again.
Yep.
So, all's good.
Yep, all is good.
2 hours later.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you're going to keep us updated, right?
Right.
Under the comments of your video, why not?
Yep.
Yep. To the world.